Welcome back to Endorse a Remorse, where I'm going to tell you about my experience with the Roomba S9 Plus and whether or not it's worth your hard-earned money. Roomba series is a line of high-quality robotic vacuums that come with a hefty price tag. We got the predecessor to the S9 Plus, the 980, back when it was the flagship product, and then we were excited to purchase the new and improved... We got the predecessor to the S9 Plus, the 980, for $999.99 back when it was the flagship product for the Roomba series. We were excited to purchase the new and improved S9 Plus for $1,500 about 8 months ago. The price has since been reduced to $1,000, the same price that we paid for the 980, so thanks a lot for that, iRobot. But anyway, the S9 Plus specs boast a smaller, lighter version of the 980 with the same 2-hour battery life and the addition of an anti-allergen filter that we were really excited about as allergen-sensitive people in a household with a dog and 2 cats that shed a lot. We were psyched about the new features of the S9 Plus, including a stronger motor with improved suction power, the ability to empty itself, and with its D-shaped design, the improved ability to get into those corners that the 980 couldn't quite reach, leaving tumbleweeds of pet hair in a couple areas of our home. Both versions are Wi-Fi capable and smart home compatible, using iRobot's patented iAdapt and vSLAM technology to scan and map your home, ensuring full coverage of the entire area. If you have never owned a Roomba, let me start by telling you, these things are a game changer. Let me know down in the comments how often you are sweeping or vacuuming your house, especially if you have kids or pets. How often are you having to get out that broom or that vacuum and sweep or vacuum? Because I gotta tell you, if I wasn't doing it every day, we'd be walking around with stuff stuck to our feet. With a Roomba, sweeping up hair daily, it's gonna be a thing of the past. And you can walk around on your hardwood floors or your regular tile floors and not have to worry about pet hair or little morsels of stuff sticking to the bottom of your feet. And it has the added value of being unanticipated entertainment when you least expect it. You don't have to think too much about it. Once you program it to do what you want it to do, it doesn't matter how busy you are, it's going to go on its way doing whatever you programmed it to do at the time you programmed to do it, and it's going to keep your floors clean. Unfortunately, no matter how cool it is, if it's not working, it's not doing what you paid for. I had high expectations set by the 980, and I anticipated the same quality with new and improved features. But after about a week of owning the S9 Plus, the battery stopped working, and we had to replace it. iRobot was really cool. We told them about the problem and they sent us a replacement battery free of charge. So even though this was a bit of a hassle, I still figured it's probably a quality product and I just got a lemon and not representative of the product as a whole. Unfortunately, sometimes the S9 Plus doesn't quite make it back home to its base. And when that happens, the lithium ion battery is damaged and it limits its ability to charge. So even with the new battery, it's been gradually losing battery power over time because it doesn't make it back to the base and it takes us time to notice, find it, and get it back on there. And now has a battery life of around 20 minutes before it has to come home and get back on the charger again. We've had a similar issue with the 980 not making it back home or just not being able to line up properly with the contacts. And in the 4 years or so that we've owned it, it hasn't created such a significant issue with the battery life for us and gives us a little bit of time to actually notice that it's not on the charger, go find it, bring it home and get it on there without damaging the battery. On the other hand, it seems like it is a more pressing issue to notice with the S9 Plus and get it back on the charger in order to retain that battery life. In addition, there are some other improvements that I would like to see out of the S9 Plus that I feel would make it more worth the money that you have to spend on this thing. The 980 has eaten many a little sock or dog toy, and it's always been easy to just pop open the roller compartment, remove the foreign object, pop that back on, and send it back into action. On the other hand, our S9 Plus ate a sock and broke one of the rollers into 3 pieces. Let me grab that real quick. Three pieces. How on earth? The rollers have the ability to be purchased separately, like in this replenishment kit, and changed out. But again, this thing is brand new. And we had the 980 for 4 years, and that has never happened. The S9 Plus frequently needs to be rescued from the edge of our living room rug that the 980 has had no issues with. So what I'd like to see is an improvement in the way it moves over transitions between different types of flooring. The S9 Plus also ran over our threshold between our hardwood floor and another type of flooring that we had and completely ripped off that threshold strip and pushed it into the room. The exposed nails on the bottom of that threshold strip actually scratched up the bottom of our Roomba and could have scratched up our floor. Also, if you have pets, I think we've all probably seen a video of what happens when the Roomba runs over a pile of dog poop. Our pets are good and don't usually go in the house, but sometimes accidents happen, and we have had the Roomba run over some dog poop and smear it all over our floor while we weren't home. What I'd like to see is some kind of sensor built into them that detects when it runs over something wet like that, so that instead of having to clean up your whole house, you end up just having to clean up the Roomba if it runs over some dog poop or some cat barf or something like that. Because right now we have to mitigate this problem by only running the Roomba when we're actually at home. Everything considered, I think that iRobot is a great brand with great ideas, but for a $1,000 investment, or $1,500 in our case, I want a product that works from the get-go. With the battery issues, the broken roller, and the constant babysitting of the S9 Plus, this product is not living up to the expectations set for me by the 980. The new features were great ideas. And while I still do believe that iRobot makes the highest quality vacuum robots out there, this one has regretfully earned the label of remorse. To find out what other products gave me remorse and the ones that I endorse, be sure to hit that subscribe button and I will show you the things that made my life easier and the ones that didn't. Be sure to also hit that bell to get notifications whenever I post my next review. Let me know down below in the comments what other products you'd like to see me review and I'll do my best. Thanks for watching Endorse Remorse and I'll see you next time. The iRobot Roomba series is a line of robotic... I'm talking to my robot friend. No matter how... Other improvements I'd like to see as well that would make the i9... The i9. Where did that even come from? The Intel chip? Unfortunately... Wait. What am I even doing? Scratch, cut, beep. Everything considered, I think that the Roomba...